Good day friends, today we will learn about the basics of laboratory practices which need to be followed in each and every lab of the biological sciences and also the chemistry or physics or whatever it may be. There are some certain basic rules are there and each and every scientist and the students need to follow all these basic guidelines. Oh yes, there are do's and do nots, especially the basics of the laboratory practices need to be followed. Yes, the basic safe practices need to be followed as per the regulations and respective safety guards need to be always followed whenever we are entering in the laboratory. And basic practices for work with the chemicals, there are varieties of the do's and understand the procedures that you intend to perform. First of all, you should know what you are going to do and ensure that equipment is maintained appropriately in a proper condition, and the highly toxic chemicals should only be used when by the people involved in the experiment and in the designed areas, and appropriately label the chemical containers. If it is acid, label with acid and label it as the hazardous, and clean glassware thoroughly and very promptly, that you have to follow, and dispose the chemicals and their waste according to the relevant guidelines. There are the pollution control board guidelines are there, accordingly you need to dispose the chemicals, glasswares and the broken glasswares appropriately, and clean up your own mess whenever its laboratory work is done. Clean it according to the standard operating protocols and decontaminate containers after the use is there. If it is they are the microbiologically intended use, then you need to decontaminate each and every container after the use. Of course, nowadays it is most of them are the especially the disposable ones. Even then, we need to decontaminate everything. And there are certain don'ts. Don't wear apparel that may become contaminated or caught on the equipment. So apparels or the wares or any other caps, etc. And some never mouth the pipette, and using the bulbs which are very much specified for the pipettes, you need to use them. And don't allow maintenance work or repairs on equipment until the decontamination is totally, it is complete. Or meanwhile, do not mesh with the equipment, and don't leave naked flames unattended in the laboratory, and always switch off the regulator of any cylinders or any other inflammable agents, and don't leave naked flames, and also don't leave equipment running or equipments overnight unless they are labeled. Please leave one with the date, name and telephone number of the person who is responsible. That's also is very much required. Or else you should totally switch off the equipment in a perfect manner, including the switch off and pulling up of the plugs from the sockets. That you need to be done. And there should not be any smoking or eating or drinking in the laboratory area. That should be strictly, it should be followed. And don't exceed the quantities of the inflammable solvents and corrosives allowed by the budget unit, and you should never store more inflammable agents in the laboratory, because whenever there is a fire accident or hazard, there is chance of the explosion. And don't store Winchesters or other chemical bottles on the floor just like that. And don't ride in the lifts with liquid nitrogen, because many times it may spill. This is one of the important thing to be followed. Don't ride in the lifts with liquid nitrogen. Don't run laboratory areas, don't walk unnecessarily, and don't carry hazardous material in stairwells and also unless in appropriate secondary containment. And never use fume cupboards as storage areas. That many students, they will store so many of their, especially the writing material, etc., in the fume hoods. And don't distract or startle others who are using the chemicals. Suppose somebody is handling the acids, and don't call it by his name unless the work is completed. Yes, one should not throw out the empty bottles, etc., in the open airflow, etc., especially in the laboratories. And Laboratory hygiene should be followed very properly. Always wash your hand thoroughly after using any of the chemicals and before leaving the laboratory. That should be followed. And always use personal protective equipment when required. Maybe the eye protection, or it must be worn when hazardous chemicals are being used. And also wear an appropriate hairstyle or restraint. Tie back the hair. If you are having the long hair, tie it back properly and put a rubber band on your head. And cover any wounds in the skin with a waterproof dressing, because many times the chemicals may spill on it and get absorbed into circulation and may cause the toxicity. Clean up spills immediately. Any of the acids or alkalis or any other chemical, use a proper material, maybe a cotton gauze or also sometimes the tissue paper with immediately. Then don't bring food or drink into the chemicals areas, and never drink or eat anything in the areas where the chemicals are stored. And don't apply any cosmetics or lipsticks or any other thing in the chemical areas. And don't smoke in the hazardous areas. And never smell or taste any of the chemical. And don't wear laboratory coats or gloves outside the hazardous areas. Just not for the style purpose. And they should be stored in laboratory and not taken into the other areas, like this tea rooms or coffee rooms or the canteens. That should be always avoided. And lab safeties, you should keep your lab and office space clean and free of clutters. And it should be kept very clean, and not as the tissue wraps or the papers in a very haphazard manner. And don't eat or drink in the laboratory, because many times it may spill over the laboratory platform. Even if your desk is in the laboratory, and even if empty, don't put any of your food, and never spill the food. Then food fridge, copy machine in a lab, never, it should never be done. Suppose if you are in the lab, there is a storage area for the freezing, then never use your this Coca-Cola or any of the drinks or water. Never store it. Then never store the chemicals in your office. Store them very properly in the area where it is designated for. Then especially the cylinders, gas cylinders, they should be marked properly, and they should be strapped with the chain, etc. And never strap many type of the cylinders very together. There many times there is a chance that the explosion may also happen. Do avoid trip hazards, because many times the wires, etc., and tubing up of the floors may be gases. They should never be put on the floor, because many times some may step on them and get the the shock, etc., or sometimes the gas may spill. And they keep the, especially the dustbins, etc., very, very clean. And do use paper labeling, and want to first drink from the bottle on the right, just like the proper labeling techniques should be done. And do maintain good laboratory cleanliness, and it's for your own safety and as well as for the other. Please maintain the laboratory in a very, very clean and the neat fashion. And the laboratory, we do not want to hear that I have got up after again. What do you think it of? Just like spilling up of some chemicals on the stand. And never postpone cleaning up of any spillover materials on the laboratory. And it has been the tool, the wonder that this, how I clean it, because many times the chemicals, especially while weighing, you should never spill the any of the chemical outside. Many times it may spill your or spoil your this, especially the weighing balance. And never keep the unused bottles very near to the weighing balance. And you always need to be careful while using the nano pure water, or you need to see whether it's a nano pure water or not. How pure you do think this nano pure water really is? So sometimes the dirty glassware, unlabeled beakers, spilled chemicals, they should never be present on your desk. They should be kept in their proper areas where they need to be stored. And protect yourself very healthy. If you have an allergy to the lab materials or suffer from a medical condition which may affect you in the laboratory, for example, diabetes or epilepsy. Some persons may have the epilepsy, then ensure that your supervisor should know it. The laboratory head should know what are the disease you are going to suffering and what are all the pills you are going to take in the emergencies. So such things should be told to your laboratory supervisor. And wear appropriate protective clothing like this glove goggles, gloves, laboratory coat and a proper shoes. And never do any of this is compromisation. Your clothing should cover the legs to the knees and shorts are not appropriate for the laboratory. And lab apron can be used to protect a very good clothing. And loose clothing should not be worn because it may dip into the chemicals or fall on the flame or sometimes, especially saris, etc. They should never be worn. Just you can, the free dress should be there. And wear shoes that completely cover your feet, especially sandals and open-toed shoes do not protect your feet from the broken glass that is frequently found in the laboratory. Also, leather shoes protect your feet from the chemical, and the canvas shoes need not be worn at all because they will never protect your feet. And apart from this one, do not apply cosmetics, eat or drink in the laboratory, and these activities are always by which you can accidentally ingest harmful chemicals. There is chance that the chemicals will spill over it and you may get that thing. And do not taste any of the chemicals. So many have got the habit of tasting the chemicals, and that should never be done. And pour from large container to smaller, and the vice versa should not be practiced. And always add acid to the water. So water should be kept down and acid should be kept up very slowly, and don't spit into the acid. A good place to remember this rule because it will spurt and put on your face, and hold your hand over the label while pouring. That should be always practiced. Work with volatile chemicals under a fume hood only. So you should have never use the open area for the volatile chemicals, and check glassware for tears or the cracks especially so they may spill over, or sometimes there is a leakage of the acid or alkalis. And heat test tubes properly at an angle, then directing the opening oppositely to you and other people in the laboratory, or else they will spark. And handle hot glassware with gloves or beaker tongs, which are meant for them only, holding them only. Simply never hold the beakers or glassware by your hand without any proper clothing. First light this match, then turn on the gas. Always that should be done. First light the match, then turn on the gas, and vice versa should never be done, because if there is leakage of the gas, then it will burst or it may explode. And don't smell any chemical directly, because if absolutely necessary to smell, use your hand to fan, to vapor your nose, or else you may get anesthetized, like just like the gases like ether, etc. They are highly explosive in nature. So, and sometimes the chloroform or any other gases may cause lot of injury to you. Then don't pipette the solutions by mouth. This is a bad practice and bad laboratory practice. And use a rubber suction bulb or other devices to fill a pipette. So very specific rubber suction bulbs are available, or else you can use the automatic pipettes with the tips properly. Wash your hands with soap and water before leaving the laboratory, and this rule applies even if you have been wearing the gloves also. So wash your hands even after removing the gloves. Never go like that only. There is chance that the gloves may have some wear and tears. So tie back loose hair. So dangling hair can fall into the Bunsen burner and catch fire, or can fall into the chemical solution. So especially PS burning hair, really it stinks. So now how to dispose the waste, dispose all the waste material according to the instructional guidelines or by the waste disposal agencies. They will provide the biological waste, how to waste disposal methods are there already, then you have to follow different protocols. Then report any accidents or unsafe conditions immediately to the higher up and never hide anything which has happened in the laboratory. That is very very important. So thanks for hearing for a such time, and please follow all the rules and regulations which need to be followed in the laboratory, and keep yourself protected from the laboratory hazardous chemical, and also make other persons to be safe with your activity. Thanks a lot.